Today, I'm going to show you 5 tips that you might not know working with layer styles. Hey, I'm Colin Smith from Photoshop Cafe, and if you are not a subscriber, hit the subscribe button right now. If you are, hit the notification. I'm going to show you 5 tips using layer styles. Let's start with the very first one here. What we're going to do is add a drop shadow just to get us started. And here's one of the things. With the drop shadow, we can do all kinds of things here. But one of the things you might not know is that we can drag these around. Look at that. Manually on the screen. Now, that doesn't just work for drop shadows. It also works for things like gradients and other things like that. So tip number 2 is we can replicate these to other objects really easily by holding down the Option key on Mac, Alt on Windows, and just click and drag. Notice as we do that, we can add these to the other ones. Okay, that's tip number 2. Tip number 3, if we right click and we choose Copy Layer Style, and we just select the rest of the layers here that we want to attach them, and we right click and we choose Paste Layer Style, now we can put the layer style on all of them without having to do it individually. All right, tip number 4, one size does not fit all. Let's grab a layer style and see where it says creative there. Let's drag and drop that layer style on there. And that looks terrible. It's a hand-me-down. It's too big for that type. And that's easy to fix. We just right-click on the word effects, choose scale effects. And now we can just go down and scale that to fit there. Because whenever you create a layer style, it's saved out in the size that it was created, so it doesn't automatically scale. So you want to scale those to make them look good. And tip number 5 is how to create a better bevel. So let's create a bevel and emboss. Just hit the little effects. You see bevel and emboss. Let's open it up. We're watching down here. Okay, so here's one of the things. We can try to get a good bevel. And it's not bad, but it doesn't really look crisp and it doesn't look sharp. And here's the trick here is to make sure you turn on a contour and make it anti-aliased. If we turn on that contour here, we can give it different shapes for that bevel. Look at that. And, you know, if we want to make it look more metallic or whatever, you know, we can do that on here. So I kind of like that one there. So if we look at this before and after the contour, see how it just gives it a lot more precision. So that's it, guys. That was short and sweet. If you like this, hit the subscribe button right now. Become part of the Cafe crew. Get a new tutorial every single week. Smash that like button into dust and add a comment. Let's get a discussion going right now. I'd love to know what your favorite layer style is. Let me know. And until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.